Hi, it's Barbara, and every week again, it is such a joy to share my passion for books. Books which have impacted me profoundly, which have expanded my mind, and this week I would read an excerpt or a poem from one of my favorite people and poets from all time, and that is Rumi. And until recently, I didn't know so much about his life, and I read the book 40 Rules of Love from Elif Shafak, where I learned that until his mid-30s, Rumi had a high position in society, but to become a poet, he had to leave all of that behind. He had to go into a place where he was mocked because he chose for poetry and he chose for that deep spiritual connection. And without his courage and the support of his friend Shams, we wouldn't be reading hundreds of years later his sublime poetry. So it took him so much courage to connect with that part of his soul and to connect with his divine purpose. So let me read the excerpt from Rumi. Out beyond ideas of wrongdoing and rightdoing, there is a field. I'll meet you there. When the soul lies down in that grass, the world is too full to talk about. And I love so much when he says, out beyond ideas of wrongdoing and rightdoing, there is a field, and I'll meet you there. This means that as humans, if we can meet each other beyond our ideas of what is right in life, what is wrong in life, beyond our personal thoughts of how the world should be. So leaving that behind and meet another human being there, whether he has another gender, whether he is another race, whether he is another religion, meet each other out of the ideas of wrongdoing and rightdoing. In that world, we meet each other in our being, just being human and being with each other. I think that's an enormous gift. And those lines gave me that fullness, that savoring of the fullness of life, life without ideas of right or wrong. You know, these are only a few lines from Rumi, but I can read you like hundreds of lines, which gave me each time again, gave me savoring that fullness of life. So I hope you enjoyed those lines as much as I did, and see you next week again. Love you. Bye-bye.